All right, we're going to practice simplifying algebraic expressions. Now, basically, you're doing the order of operations as usual, except that it's an algebraic expression, so there are going to be some variables. So you might need to use the distributive property, you might need to combine like terms, etc. Okay, first I want to remind you about the distributive property. The distributive property is basically a way to multiply. It's really a multiplication. So it's a way to multiply when you can't simplify inside the parentheses. Okay, so that's something to keep in mind. So let's say we had a problem like this, 3 plus 4 parentheses x plus 5. Now, using the order of operations, the first step would be to do anything inside parentheses, but if you've already gone over the videos on adding like terms, what a term is, combining like terms, inside the parentheses here, x and 5 are, you know, different things. They're not like terms, so I can't combine any further. So I've done that. Then we look for some exponents, don't have that. Next thing would be multiplication, and that's right here. 4 next to the parentheses means multiply, and that's what I'm talking about. You're just doing the order of operations because in this case you can't simplify inside the parentheses. If it was 3 plus 5, you would not use the distributive property. You would add 3 and 5 together. So I need to do this next. Notice I do not add the 3 and 4 first. I'm doing the order of operations. So let's go. We write the 3 plus, and now I distribute the 4. So I have 4 times x, which is 4x. Plus 4 times 5, which is 20. All right, so we've done our multiplication from left to right, and now we do any addition or subtraction, and in this case all there is addition, and here's where we're going to have to add like terms. So two constants here are the like terms, so our final answer is 4x plus 23. Now, how would we do this problem? It says subtract 5x minus 3 from 2x plus 1. This is like a word problem in a way. There's no addition or subtraction. It's telling us to take the 5x plus 3 right here, and we're going to subtract it from the 2x plus 1. So that means we've got to start off with the 2x plus 1 and then take away the 5x minus 3. Okay? Does that make sense? So we're subtracting this from something. So I'm taking the 5x minus 3 away from something else. All right. Now, again, order of operations, you first would see if you could simplify inside the parentheses. And neither of them have like terms, so we can't simplify within either of them. Now, the next thing would be to do multiplication. Now, this time there is a 1 in front of here, but, you know, that's neither here nor there. You don't need to really distribute there. So next comes addition and subtraction. The subtraction here, be careful. You've got to distribute your minus sign, which means you're going to change all the signs inside the parentheses. So 2x plus 1 in parentheses is the same thing as just 2x plus 1. There's nothing in front of there, so I could remove the parentheses. But now I need to write this as a minus 5x, and I need to change the sign here to a plus 3. So you're distributing your minus sign inside those parentheses. All right, now we're back to addition and subtraction, and we simply combine like terms. So remember, even though this is minus 5x, you could think of this as plus negative 5x. So we've got the 2x minus 5x, and we've got to combine the 1 and the 3. Now, this step that I'm writing right here, you don't need to write. I'm just showing you what the like terms are, and you also could write plus and negative if you prefer. So I've got negative 3x plus 4, or that is the same thing as 4 minus 3x. I like to write the variable part first, but it's correct writing it this way as well. All right, here's a problem with decimals. So there's no parentheses, so we're going to combine like terms here. Although we have all these minuses, remember you could think of all of them as adding the opposite. So we have an x term right here, and let's see if there's another x term. Here's another like term, because they both have the same variable part. So if we combine those together, we just do the 2.9 minus 2.8. If you need to, you could write it out over the side to get 0.1 or 0.1. So those are going to just be 0.1x or 0.1x. It's up to you if you want to write the 0. Some people do that so it's real clear where the decimal point is. All right, and then we have a constant here, negative 0.9 and negative 0.5. So remember, that's really like plus a negative and plus a negative. So you're adding two negatives together, so your answer is going to be negative. So you know it's going to be negative, right? And we can go over on this our side to do the scratch work. We simply add, you're adding 9/10 and 5/10 together, right? If you had the same sign. So that's 1.4. And those are unlike terms, right? So we're done. So it's 1/10 x minus 1.4 or 0.1x, however you want to read that. All right, let's go on to this next one. Again, we can't simplify inside the parentheses. So the next thing would be your multiplication, and that's really your distributive property here. So the first part here is you're going to take the opposite of everything inside these parentheses. So to remove the parentheses, you're going to change all the signs in the parentheses. So it's negative x minus 3y and a plus 6. That's distributing your negative signs to all terms inside the parentheses, right? And what's going on over here, we're going to have to distribute the 2 inside these parentheses. So let's see, I have 2 times 4x, which is 8x, and then minus 2 times 7. Now again, you can either write plus negative 14 or write minus 14. So now we're going to look for some like terms. So let's see what I have here. I've got an x term. Do I have anything else with the variable part being x? Right here. Now we've got to be careful. When I have this minus in front of the x, what is the coefficient? Anyone remember? That's a 1. So this represents negative 1x plus 8x. So what's that give you? If you're going to add those coefficients, negative 1 plus 8 is 7x. So 7x. All right. Now, I've got a 3y. Are there any other terms of the variable part of y? No. So I can't combine that with anything. So that's in the next term, minus 3y. And let's see what else we have here. We've got a plus 6 and a negative 14. 6 minus 14 or 6 plus negative 14, that's going to give you negative 8. And so there we go. Now, you want to always write your answers as minus 8 as opposed to plus negative 8. It's more simplified to write the answer as minus 8. All right, why don't you try this one? Put it on pause and try it, and then follow along with me as I do it. All right, so inside parentheses, I have unlike terms, so I can't combine. So the next thing would be multiplication, which is right here, and that's the distributive property again. But remember, you're not only distributing 11, you're distributing the negative along with it. So it's negative 11 times each term in parentheses. So remember not to do 14 minus 11. No, 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 no. So we still have 14. And now, negative 11 times 3m is negative 33m. Negative 11 times 2n is negative 22n. So I've done my distributive property. The minus 5m is not in the parentheses, so you don't distribute across to the negative 5m. You just write that term down. Now we're going to look for like terms. Well, I have a constant here of 14 and no other constants. Let's see, I have an m term here and another m term, so those can be combined. So I have a negative 33 and a negative 5. So if you add those together, negative 33 plus negative 5 is negative 38, and the variable part was m. Remember, we just write the variable part down. And then we have a negative 22n. There are no other like terms with that. So I hope this is what you got. Now remember, the order of the terms does not matter. I like to write it in alphabetical order, or you could start with the M and the M, and you could put the plus 14 at the end. It's really up to you. One more. Try this on your own and then come back. Okay, fractions. Let's go for it. Just do the distributive property with fractions. 1/3 times 9x minus 1/3 times 6, and then change the signs here, minus x and plus 2. And we go ahead and simplify that to 3x minus 2 minus x plus 2, which is 2x, since the negative 2 and plus 2 cancel. That's it.
I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.